The quickest and easiest way to access the camera from the lock screen is to swipe left. Works on phones with Face ID or Touch ID, and you can grab any part of the screen except on a notification and swipe. No need to curl up your right thumb and hit the small camera icon in the bottom right corner of Face ID phones and hold it there until you get the haptic feedback. Okay?
That's
I stumbled across this accidentally once. I swiped and it's like, oh, now look where I am.
I forget about, until his email came in, I don't think I'd done that in years. But it is a much faster way of getting the camera up. The next one, I think, is like the pièce de résistance of this. Yeah.
Yeah, to me, that was like magic when I tried this.
Yeah.
The second tip. The quickest and easiest way to turn off the flashlight if you're on the lock screen is to swipe left a little bit to start revealing the camera. The flashlight will then turn off, and you can release your finger or move it back to the right to restore your lock screen. Nice. And then the third tip.
No, that, I don't want to gloss over that. Like, that's the one that blew me away, because it's a pain in the neck to, like, I don't know why, but turning off the flashlight is always, like, just wonky. And just that quick little flick, it does it. I love it. Yep.
And then the third tip is not so quick to describe. I finally got my first Face ID phone, a 13 mini. Had to get it before they stopped making the mini. I love the small phones. Yes, I do too. There are dozens of us. I think there are more than dozens.
I don't know. I am missing my, well, I'm not missing it. It's literally right in front of me. I am using a new camera this week, and I moved up from the iPhone XR with reincubate camo to my iPhone 13 mini with reincubate camo. And it's a better lens. I mean, I think it's even better. But yeah. So there are dozens of us.
Yep. So to continue, for phones with Face ID, the quick tip is that you don't need to enable Control Center in the Allow Access When Locked list within the Face ID and Passcode section of the settings. If you need to use Control Center from the lock screen, most of the time the phone will already be unlocked by Face ID within seconds of waking, making Control Center available. When I use Touch ID phones, I always disabled Control Center from the lock screen because I didn't want someone to be able to grab my locked phone and put it in airplane mode, thus thwarting Find My iPhone.
Oh.
Sneaky.
Wait, what? I never thought about that security vector. You know, I mean, I always say we choose our place in the continuum, right, between ultimate security and ultimate convenience. But that one, like, that even gets my attention. I tend to choose my place far closer to convenience than security. But even like that there's a good reason. So you just go into settings and control center and turn off the where do you do this? Remind me again, John. Share that one more time.
Allow access when locked.
Yeah, where is that though?
Oh, Face ID and passcode. Allow access when locked. So
okay, and that's where you can do those granular things. Nice. Kansas Dave was sharing two Siri commands. I like to call them incantations because, as Kansas Dave points out, they are for turning the flashlight on and off. Siri Lumos turns the flashlight on. Siri Nox turns the flashlight off. And I'm intentionally not saying the hey word just in case my voice is close enough to yours that I would actually get your phone or mine behind me here. So these are obviously from Harry Potter, I assume, correct? That's where they come from. But Kansas Dave in our chat at MacGeekab.com/Discord was the person who pointed this out. Right? That's Harry Potter, right, John?
Could be.
Okay. I thought you were a Harry Potter person, but I'm pretty sure those are Harry Potter commands. Thank you, Kansas Dave. Amazing.